mother, my mother's mother, stayed in the siege of Leningrad the whole time, all 900 days.
Wow.
And you know that people had nothing to eat and they were absolutely weak and they could hardly move. And one day when she was coming home from the shop where she was given that 125 grams of bread for each of her two children that stayed in the siege, and you remember that one of them was my mother, she saw a woman on the street laying there. She was alive. And she begged, "Help me to stand up, please. I can move. I have to move. Help me to stand up." And my grandma was standing near her, and it was a very hard decision. She said, "If I helped her, I could fall down myself, and then I would never stand up." And I didn't help her. She never knew what had happened with that woman. But in my family, every time when they gathered, they always drank to that woman.
Oh.
Well, let's, with this as I promised my family. After the Second World War, along the Nevsky Prospect, it was a march of German prisoners of the war. The officers were at the head. The soldiers were at the back. They had to go along the Nevsky Prospect, and all the citizens, all those who suffered 900 days of siege, they were standing along the street. And I talked to one of that soldiers. He came here later, just to visit this country. And he was crying in Pavlovsk. And he apologized, saying, "Violetta, it was me who did it. It was me." And I had nothing to tell him. He was a soldier, and he was in the army. That's all. And he said that the most horrible moment of his life was that very moment when he was going along Nevsky Prospect, and that women and children who looked like mummies, they didn't look like normal people. Women at the age of 25 looked like 60 years old. They kept silence. No one yelled. No one said any rude word. They were just standing and looking. And he said, "Since that time, I always need some sound, some noise nearby. I can never stand in the silence."
Wow.
Mm. At the same time, that prisoners of the war who had to rebuild houses, they put on houses inside the city, my granny told me that when they had some extra soup, they always went there to that houses where the soldiers worked to feed them a little bit. That very women who lost their kids, their husbands, and their health during the siege, they fed those who tried to kill them. Near St. Petersburg, there are two big cemeteries, German cemetery and Russian cemetery. Soldiers of both armies are buried there. Russian women are taking care of that cemeteries. We have to forgive, but we have not forget. Because if we forget, we start doing the same mistakes. And I hope we shall never in our life have any situation like that. Because if the war starts now, it will be the end of the world. And I very much believe that very soon all our boys will come back home, and our mothers, your mothers, will never think